Now, here's Chris.
Yes, good morning, everybody. Welcome to the Chris Moyles Show. It's Friday. Woohoo! Where's Pippa? Where's Pippa?
Oh, here she comes.
Number
what
two.
What time do you call this?
Race against time. As soon as I was like, the red light.
Can't believe you've only just arrived
Pippa's
at work.
Late today.
You're meant to be in before the show.
Yeah.
To prepare everything.
Hey.
Executive producer. If you listen, if it's too much for you.
Yeah.
And you want to, drop down.
Yeah.
To driving the desk.
Oh well, James can. I can swap roles with James.
Yeah. No, Pippa's been there all morning. She's just. Has a nervous wee every day.
That's it.
Well, it's just, I tell you what, we you come flush. In the studio and we all start chatting.
Oh, it's our fault.
Are you flush?
Did I flush?
Yeah.
I thought you said, am I flush?
Oh, there she goes. There it is.
Yeah.
Right, we're live on Global Player if you want to watch us. Good morning, everybody. I've had a shave.
Oh, look
hair
at you.
Needs a bit of stuff on it, but yeah, I've had a shave.
Very nice.
Oh, I had a good groom up yesterday.
Oh, hello.
A good groom up. Let me just tell everyone to tune in. Well, I'll tell you in a minute.
Yeah.
Head, shoulders, knees and toes.
I didn't do my knees.
They're
very hairy.
Hairy knee. We've always said that. But
open Global Player and then it should be on the homepage. So good morning, you can watch us live. And if you've got the Global Player on your telly, you can watch us through your TV.
We're kind of on television.
Open up Global Player, go to the Radio X page on the telly.
Yeah.
That is, and then it might just be there. I don't know. I've never seen it because we only stream on there during our show, so I don't know how it works. But if Kate and Nick can do it, then anyone can do it.
If they can do it, anyone can.
Kate and Nick watch us every morning in the telly in their bedroom.
It's nice, isn't
it? Hi, guys. Yeah. Good morning. Hello. I can see you too. So, yeah, Global Player. You can watch us now live for the first 25. And if you're watching the replay on Global Player, or YouTube, which we're not allowed to mention, because it's all about Global Player, but it's also available on YouTube, then hello to you, Lazy Bones.
We can call this television. I've not done television for years. We should call this television.
I like you, Dom, used to be on television.
Yes, that's right. We did a bit of TV.
Yeah.
Not for a while now, sadly.
And then I got taken off the television.
Oh, man.
But you did like a good few series, didn't you?
Did five series until the woman in charge of Channel 4 didn't like me anymore, and then she took me off.
Yeah.
She's gone now.
But you did five. I think five feels like a good amount of series. That's more than what a lot of them do.
You're right. It's more. I did more series. All right, listen to this. Than Ricky Gervais did of The Office.
Whoa,
I did
whoa.
More series of Quiz Night. I did more Quiz Nights than Fawlty Towers.
I was about to say, yeah. Then he did two.
I'm just dropping it there.
Yeah, yeah.
Just saying.
Oh yeah.
Just saying. Which means I'm better than Ricky Gervais and John Cleese. With a little space left over.
Yes.
And Aaron Sorkin, he only did one season of Studio 60 on the Sunset Strip, one of the greatest shows ever made.
I don't know why they only did one series.
It doesn't cost a fortune.
Brilliant. Is that what it was?
Yeah, it cost an absolute
did
fortune.
It? It was so good.
Anyway. I had a proper groom-up
What?
One second.
The grooming, please. You missed a bit.
Yes, hello. Right. Don't talk about the grooming. It's too far. All right. Okay, love you too, bye-bye.
That's too far.
Oh, was that Ofcom?
That was Tiff.
Right.
Yeah, she's saying your listeners don't need to
know. They don't say about the grooming.
She said, I don't need to know. They don't need to know.
That's like a ringtone from a cartoon in the 70s. That's brilliant. That's like when Top
Cat. Hold on, the phone's going here.
Yeah.
I thought that was our studio phone going off.
It's good, isn't it?
How have we got a phone?
Hello, Chris Moyles.
Retro.
It's just comedy character here. Anyway, I had a big old groom up. That's what I did.
Yeah, man.
Manscape.
Well, I needed to shave.
Yes.
So I thought, I'll have a shave. Now, when you start getting older, kids, apparently, Dominic's told me.
Yeah, I told you this a while ago.
As you start to get older, as a man, and I believe to a certain extent as a woman, let's ignore that.
Yeah.
Your head, for those of you who don't know about biology, your head in here is a brain. Okay.
That's it.
And the rest of the inside of your skull is hair. All right. And that's growing all the time.
Well.
And it comes out of like your eyebrows, your head, obviously, comes everywhere.
Yeah.
Right. And as you get older, the hair starts to grow faster and faster.
It's like a science
show. So it comes out your nose, comes out your ears.
Yeah.
And you're like, I've got hair in my ears. I've never had hair in my ears
hairy
before.
Hairy ears.
But as you get older, because your head's just full of hair and it's got to get out. I think if you reach the age of 90, it starts coming out of your mouth.
Yeah, pretty much. Absolutely.
So I have one and a, one or two, but definitely one rogue eyebrow.
Yes.
On each of my eyebrows.
Yeah.
Now I have about two or three that grow longer than the rest.
Yeah.
But one is like the Usain Bolt of eyebrow hairs, and he's like, "Oi, finished. Where are you?" And he goes from my eyebrow, right?
Yeah.
If I let it grow, I honestly think it would then have a coffee with my hairline,
yeah,
and then those two would just become one.
Please grow it.
No.
Oh, yeah.
Please grow it. Charity.
But I've got the same one on the other side, so I've got two long eyebrows.
Yeah.
Now, when I say long, I'm talking that long, but I notice it.
Are they particularly wiry, those ones?
They're just the same as all the others. Oh. So I have like, it's like a podium after the Olympics, right? So you've got, he's in the lead. There's your silver, and then this one's your bronze.
Yeah.
And it's on both sides.
Okay.
So, when I've noticed them, I clip them, I nip them, right?
Okay.
So that my eyebrows are all the same length.
What do you use to nip, by the way?
I've got like a little trimmer thing.
A little trimmer,
right?
Yeah, lovely.
Yeah.
So, you get hair starting to grow out your ears. Now,
yeah.
I don't have much hair growing out. Again, it's like one, maybe two little hairs going,
yeah.
Oh, we've escaped the skull.
You're not a hairy man, really, are
not
you?
Not really.
I noticed one on Toby's ear. It was about 2 years ago, which I had to tell him about. And it was... I'm not joking.
Inside or outside?
Outside,
yeah.
On the actual flap,
right,
if you will, at the top. And it was about...
Sorry.
It was about 10 centimetres long.
Oh, yeah.
It was incredible. I had to point out to him. It was
how
about a couple of years ago.
That? Look at him.
Because you never look at him.
So, So, I keep on top of it all.
Yeah.
Right? Mm. And I meet older people.
Yeah.
And I speak to them, older men. I like to meet older men, Dom. I'm in the park. I'm meeting older men.
It's just what you do.
And
can we stop judging that?
And you can see the men who have never trimmed their eyebrows, ever.
Yeah.
And it's like they've got two caterpillars and just stuck them on.
It's the Dennis Healy back in the day.
Yeah.
Well, I told you, my friend's dad can rest his glasses on his eyebrows.
No,
takes them off his eyes and rests them.
That's
there.
Too
not
bushy.
For me. Not for me.
Too
for
bushy.
And it's the same with the ear hair. You know, when you're starting to plait your ear hair.
Yeah, that's it.
Just cut it.
Yeah.
Just cut, that's the sign.
I had my eyebrows threaded.
did you?
On the morning of our wedding.
Did you?
Yeah.
Because they were getting a bit rogue. And actually, they could probably do with doing again. Lucy bought me a voucher to go and get them.
Now, so you're going to get your eyebrows threaded again?
Again, yeah.
See, but you won't come with me for a manicure?
No, I'm not fussed about the
no, I'm sorry. I don't understand that.
Because I'm...
That's like you walking into work every day...
Yeah.
...in a wig, full makeup, lipstick, dress,
yeah,
high heels...
Yeah.
...and always going, why don't you do drag? And you go... Don't be so ludicrous.
I'm like you. I get the odd real rogue one.
Yeah.
And it can... I mean, cause like it's got a mind of its own. One of them's particularly got a mind of its own.
Yeah.
And it needs, you know, taken down a peg or two.
Right. So,
that's what I'm going to do.
So here's what I did yesterday. So I trim... I always just give it a little trim. Mm. Right? And this will be fine now. And again, I don't believe it grows. I believe it escapes.
Right.
Because I never notice... It's just ever so slightly higher than the others.
Yeah.
You only notice it when it's like, I'm here! And you're like, oh, God, there it is.
Yeah.
You need to get rid of it.
Yeah.
Anyway, last summer, I died inside.
Oh, no.
Because I've always been conscious of the hair since the hair started to grow.
Yeah.
You're looking in the mirror one day and you're going, I've got a hair on my earlobe. What is that? Just one.
Yeah.
Waving. Get rid of that.
Yeah, yeah.
So I'm always trying to keep on top of it.
Yeah.
Anyway, we're away with our friends and their two young daughters.
Oh,
right.
No. Honest. They're honest.
They
kids,
are.
Aren't
no
they?
Filter.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. I mean, they stabbed me. They stabbed me through the heart.
Oh.
They got that spear through my heart and my soul.
Yeah.
And I didn't even know I had one.
They needed tweezers, didn't they?
Absolutely.
And do you know what it was?
Go on.
It wasn't these fellas.
Oh,
it wasn't the ones I've been talking about.
No.
Apparently,
that was a new one.
There's two little lines, right, on the edge of my eyebrow. So if you go up and then you move to the right of your eyebrow, on that side towards the edge of your eye.
Yeah.
And I'm like, I've never even noticed it before. It's kind of like when it's filtering out a little bit,
right? Yeah,
nothing to worry about. No, longer than the others. And they're like... You need to sort your eyebrows out. Look at the state of them. I'm like, what are you talking about?
No.
My eyebrows, they're absolutely better. No, down here. There's a bit of hair. There's hair there. I mean, I'm talking two hairs.
Right.
Why are they looking that good?
You know, like when an aeroplane flies through the sky?
Yeah.
And then the last little bit is just tailing out. That's what I think eyebrows look like. They kind of just tail out a little bit. Yeah. That sent me paranoid. Paranoid.
I bet it did.
Normal people don't look at your face like that, don't forget.
They're not
just
normal kids.
No, but kids are different, like, because they don't mind staring.
I say they're kids, one of them's in their 20s, but...
I mean,
right, yeah.
I mean, in another universe, Gav would be dating her, you know what I mean?
Right, got you.
She's that age.
It makes you feel old when they point stuff out like that, though.
I felt like...
Yeah.
Old man with big, bushy, resting your glasses on top of the eyebrows guy. So, anyway. So, I'm trying to keep on top of this.
Yeah. Are you going to get threaded?
Do you know, I've never done it.
I've never done it.
I keep on top of it, so I don't think, if you look, they're really not that.
It's very
my eyebrows are not that bushy at all, So I've got to be careful when I cut them, because I can't, there's little or nothing there.
It's one of the most painful things ever.
Oh, and then in that case, no.
But it's very clever.
It's the only reason I don't have a sleeve of tattoos, is because I don't like pain.
Well, did you ever do Cat's Cradle when you were like 4 years old with string?
No, because I was a boy.
Oh, yeah. Oh, I did that. I got beaten up for that. So I used to do Cat's Cradle or whatever. But that's basically what they do. They get two things.
No, thanks.
It's a dark art.
No, buy a trimmer and keep on top of it yourself.
You should have your bikini line waxed if you think that's painful.
Oh, yeah. I bet.
That's up and in.
That's
off.
I think they're doing it wrong, Pip.
Yeah.
Yeah, I really do. I think they just go around the outside.
You've gone to
Charlie Taylor,
friends.
Yeah.
They get,
they
like.
Yeah. Well, I guess they've got to, haven't they?
Get a magnifying glass out.
Anyway, I had a good old groom up. I didn't do everything.
Right.
I didn't do Stephen and the twins.
Okay, we'll leave him for another day.
Oh, you didn't?
No, I didn't, because I had time. I'll do it later.
Yeah.
I'll FaceTime you.
Oh, excellent.
But I did. I used to get hairs on my hand here. Hmm. Like a couple of hairs. I didn't like it.
I get some there as well. Right? Actually, just on the side.
So I shaved it off.
Yeah.
Like, I'm talking like...
Oh, but doesn't it grow back more if you shave it?
No, not really.
Okay.
But I was really worried. You won't understand this reference.
No, I don't.
I used to look at my hands and go, I'm like a young Richard Keys.
Yeah.
And
Richard Keys.
And Andy.
Do you remember that?
He had hairy hands. And like, you know, like Dom has hairy palms. It's the other side.
Yeah, it's the other side for him.
Someone's put, how bored are you right now, James? James looks completely zoned out.
James is dying to grow hair. He's dying to grow. Yeah. He's been growing that beard since he was 16.
When you shave, James,
yeah,
I think like it feels like there's more growing back. It's only because you've cut them all off at the same time quite bluntly, so it feels like they're all
growing. He's never
back,
shaved.
But isn't it because there's you cut it off, it's a solid end rather than it tailing off?
That's right.
Right.
It doesn't mean hair grows back quicker or anything. You've just... Mm. But you do cut it off mid-hair.
Yes, right. Yeah.
Yeah.
Currently Googling Richard Keys' hand.
Okay, you do that. Knock yourselves out.
Oh, that's Richard. Oh, that's him.
Yeah.
Oh,
look at
that.
I know.
That is photoshopped.
No, it's not.
See, that's what I don't...
That's not his
hand. I don't want that. I don't want that. Piltdown hand man.
That might be photoshopped, actually. That
Piltdown man hand.
That can't be real.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't need it. I don't need it.
My friend... No. Do I say that?
Oh, you're going to say it.
Oh, you've got it now.
Well, name them first.
My friend had...
Merlin.
...fun times with someone.
Oh, not Merlin.
Not Merlin.
Who was blessed with hair. Shall we say?
Right.
Blessed. Because it is, you know.
Yeah, it's a blessing.
But because this man had manscaped.
Right.
But he'd only manscaped from the middle of his...
The perfect timing. Just give me 1 second.
Middle of it.
6:45, you're listening to Radio X. That's Radio X, the name of this radio station. Write it down if you need to remember who you're listening to right now. That's right, it's the Chris Moyles Show on Radio X. And it's Friday. Welcome to the weekend. And it's a bank holiday weekend at that as well. So I hope you got Monday off. Nice 3 days away from the grind of work, says a man in a nice air-conditioned studio. Let's get back to the music now with a classic from ABBA, Shabba. So your mate had it off with this hairy fella.
Well, and He'd manscaped, but only from the middle of his thighs to like, because he was very hairy, and he looked like he was wearing a little pair of white shorts.
And she told you all about this, obviously.
Cut out the important bits and then left everything else.
Really?
Wow.
And she's still, you know.
Well, from what I can make out.
How is Merlin? She all right?
Was it Merlin?
Are they still together?
No.
Can I ask you a question?
It's when she was in a bit of a phase.
Can I ask a question?
Yeah, go on.
Was it you?
No, it wasn't.
Okay, all right, just check. All right.
No, a friend.
Yeah, a friend.
Yeah. No. There's a lot of detail there.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, no, we live together. That's the thing.
What, you in the hairy man?
It's Toby.
Toby.
Toby went through the man phase.
Yeah.
It's just one of my friends. Actually, I haven't mentioned her on air yet.
Oh, okay.
So, I don't know, process of elimination when it happens.
It's the one friend you haven't talked about. She's now listening. Go, ah. What's her name again, did you say?
It's all right, it's all right. Jemima?
Yeah.
Oh. Puddle duck. anyway, fine.
I don't think it's Jemima.
I know a Jemima puddle duck.
You know a Jemima puddle duck?
Yeah.
Do you?
Yeah, I know someone called Jemima. So I called her puddle duck.
Yeah.
One day.
Did she like that?
She was very confused. She didn't know understanding of the reference. This is the girls I was talking about earlier to she one of their friends.
I'd never heard of Jemima puddle
duck. I'm like, ah, puddle duck. And everyone else who's older is going, yeah, puddle duck, good one. She's like this.
Yeah, no, I have.
I'm sorry.
Puddle duck, you just called me. I'm like, yeah, Jemima puddle duck. Jemima puddle duck. Now, that's like someone saying to you, hey, Dominic.
Oh.
Dominic Falangawang. And you go, what? And everyone going, yeah, Falangawang. Yeah. Dominic Falangawang? Yeah. You know.
Have no, you heard of puddle duck, James?
Yeah.
Yeah.
He's friends with Peter Rabbit.
Peter Rabbit?
Yeah.
Beatrix Potter?
Yeah.
Potter.
Potter?
Written in Cumbria?
Yeah, a bit of Potter, innit?
Yeah.
Potter.
Do you know what Zan came out with yesterday? Which
bit of Potter?
It's like young people, right? I know I've got children. God, it's annoying sometimes. She's not annoying, but you know, the whole thing. She came out with, it means because Zan's 18 now. She goes, means I can vote in the Jenny Lek, doesn't it?
Oh, no.
Oh, what?
No.
I could vote in the Jenny Lek.
No. No.
Even James wouldn't say
how much
it.
Time are you saving?
I think if you call it a Jenny Lek, you shouldn't be allowed to vote.
It was the...
It's
took
two syllables, saving.
Jenny... No.
No.
General election
like
to
it.
Jenny Lek.
No.
Three syllables.
Seriously. She went, that's
general,
what everyone on TikTok's saying.
General.
Everyone calls it everyone calls it Jenny Lek.
But don't... Listen, the fact that James just said he likes that, that should back up how you feel.
Exactly.
Bearing in mind, James shortens Morrison's to Mozzers, Sainsbury's to Sainos, and Asda to The Asda. He actually makes it longer and thinks it's a shortened version.
Yeah.
Therefore...
Sense?
Thick as mince.
Yeah. Where do you stand on co-op? Because that doesn't take that long.
Co-op.
Yeah.
Right. Don't mess with that.
Don't mess with it. Yeah. Don't mess with it.
Don't be silly.
Right, I've got to put my glasses on.
Oh, yes. It's
time. Hi there, ladies.
Jenny Lek.
And fellas.
They suit you.
Chris Moyles here. How you doing? Shall I do my trick? Shall I do my Eric Morecambe?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, I'll do my Eric Morecambe.
No. This is for the global player peeps.
Yeah.
Way!
That's good, isn't it? That's
always way!
Good.
That was a glasses wiggle for
thank
those
you.
Who can't
see. Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you, Kiefer, for explaining.
Oh, yeah, he did, didn't he?
One of my favourite half hours of radio, by the way, Kiefer Sutherland yesterday. Anyway, sorry, crack on.
Somebody said to me yesterday, I saw Kiefer Sutherland on his show yesterday. He looked drunk. And I went, yeah, but you know, to be fair, you know why that is.
Why?
He was drunk.
Oh. So.
Now, who would like to win some money? How would you like to win cold, hard cash? Now, I need to say, I don't know if it is cold, hard cash. It is money. Now, a lot of people think that cash is physical. This will be a bank transfer. So it will have no temperature to it.
Yeah.
So
it's digital money, guys.
Please don't think that we will be freezing notes.
Mm.
And then delivering them to you, and you have to wait for them to thaw out before you can spend them. It's a bank transfer, so it's probably a digital transfer. So.
Yep.
I'm going away.
Oh.
I'm going away for a little bit.
Are you?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm having Monday off.
Are you? Have you cleared that with the boss?
It's in the contract.
Do you know what? If you're having Monday off, I'll have Monday off. If you're doing that, I'll do it.
Oh.
Yeah.
Well, if you're not going to be in, then...
You don't know.
Oh, well, if you lot...
No, you're producing.
We'll all hang out together.
You're producing, whichever Doylem gets breakfast on Bank Holiday Monday.
Toby.
Oh, no, sorry. Anyway, we've got money to give away.
Yeah.
Now, this money could be in your bank this afternoon. Seriously, before you finish work, you could have the money in your account. And how much money we're talking? Sure, I'll tell you. How about £5,000?
Whoa.
£5,000 in your bank today. Mm-hmm. And all you have to do is text the word WIN and send it to 83936. That's it. You write the word WIN and you send it to 83936. That's it. Not Wayne, not cash,
no,
not your name, just WIN 83936. Now, that text is going to cost £2 plus your standard network rate. We're going to close the lines at 8 o'clock this morning. If you text after that, you won't be entered, but you may still be charged. It's Friday, May 24th, 2024, at 6:52 in the morning. If you're watching the replay, don't text. If you're watching live, or if you, you know, great. If you're listening on catch-up, don't text. But if you're listening live, you do need to be 18 or over to play. And all the rules, including online and free entry, are at radiox.co.uk. £5,000 in your bank this afternoon, ahead of the bank holiday weekend. Imagine you finish work and maybe Friday night's pizza night with the kids. Maybe you go for a couple of drinks with the boys. Maybe a bit of shopping with the girls on Saturday. Maybe it's Sunday lunch with your mate and their kids or whatever. Whatever it is, £5,000. I'd love £5,000 in my bank this weekend.
It's a lovely amount, isn't it?
What if Global suddenly went, you've done a great job this year, Chris, just want to give you £5,000 in your bank today. Oh. I would be, like, over the moon.
Incredible.
Way more than our competition winner will probably react.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Yeah. They'll probably be double parked.
Cheers, I've got to go on the school run.
Sorry, I'm running a bit late. Can we make this quick?
So your text will cost £2 plus your standard network rate. Close the lines at 8 o'clock this morning, Friday, May 24, 2024. If you text after that, you won't be entered, but you may still be charged. You do need to be 18 over to play. All of the rules, including online and free entry at radiox.co.uk. All you got to do to be with a chance of winning £5,000 is to text the word WIN and send it to 83936. Has anyone done it yet?
Yes.
Good. Yeah. So that's one person that we know of has text. Done. £5,000. Someone has to win. Why shouldn't it be you? You deserve it. You're a nice person. Text the word WIN and send it to 83936. That's the word WIN to 83936. Text now. You could be winning £5,000. £5,000! Thank you.
That's a lot of money.
Oh, £5,000.
Great.
Do you know what? Do you know what I'd do?
Go on.
If I won £5,000, Tiff's away. She's working away tonight.
Mm-hmm.
So it's me and the cats.
Free house.
We're having a party.
Yeah.
Me and the cats. Do you know what I'd do?
Go on.
£5,000 it is.
Yeah.
It's not three, it's five.
Five.
Yeah.
And get a Domino's.
Oh,
no,
hang on.
Way.
Well, it's £5,000, isn't it? You can afford it.
Yeah.
Would you do old Chris and get a couple and then pretend you had friends round?
Oh, no. That's only if they did a twofer. I never bought two pizzas. It was only if it was a two for one.
If there was an offer on.
Yeah.
Fair.
Yeah. I mean,
I could eat pizza.
I have over-ordered since.
Right.
Yeah.
And may still have shouted pizzas here as I'm walking towards the door.
Lads.
And there's no one else in the house but me.
That story is told in one of your books. I can't remember which one it is. Is it the first one or the second one? I can't remember.
I was ordering a pizza on the phone. They said, we're doing a two for one. You get the second pizza for free. Do you want another pizza for free? I was on my own in my flat in the big days. And I thought, yes, I want an extra pizza for free. So to imply that there were many people living with me, I went, hold on a second. Lads, do we get an extra pizza for free? Should we get another one? Yeah? Yeah, go on, I'll have another one.
Oh, it's
I was totally on my own.
It's lovely.
Oh, that is,
It's when you get a Christmas card from the local Chinese or Indian restaurant.
Yeah.
That's when you know you need to stop.
They sent me, they sent me a calendar once.
It's when you get one, when you start to, you know, diet and look after yourself, it's when you get a We Miss You card.
Yeah, we haven't seen you for ages.
Profits are down. Please, sir, come back.
Yeah.
That's bad. Anyway, good luck if you're going for the £5,000. Somebody's got to win it. We'll close the lines at 8. We'll make the phone call just after 8. Answer the phone. Say, oh my God, is it me? Yes, it's you. And you'll get £5,000. Thank you for watching the first 25. We're keeping on going. It's Friday, Platinum Hour Day. Got a cracker from 9 o'clock. Flick the threes. We'll see you in three. The Chris Moyles Show.
The Chris Moyles Show.